Hello, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. Smart plugs are one of the best-selling smart home products on the market, alongside things like smart speakers, of course. The idea of them is great. You can easily turn your household appliances on and off from anywhere in the world. Or you can set up timers and automated routines to do this smartly, which is pretty nice. But within the slightly grandiose marketing of them, many smart plugs fail to mention one simple fact: that they're often fairly pointless. I wonder why they don't mention that in the marketing. You even have to scroll down quite a long way to find mention of this with the Amazon smart plug. If you keep scrolling, then halfway down the page, amongst lots of really pretty marketing pictures, there's a single text-only sentence saying that they only work with appliances that have a mechanical switch, which is a little bit annoying. In other words, right, let's make myself a lovely cup of coffee by turning on my smart plug. Oh, it's on, but nothing's happened. Can't work. Ah, wait. You need to turn it on there, and you need to do that. Oh, this smart plug's pointless. Ah, fine, let me just make myself a cup of tea instead with my kettle. Let's turn it on. It's on, what's it? Come on. Ah, gotta click that, didn't you? Right, so when buying a smart plug for an appliance, there are three types of appliances or switches that you actually need to consider. Firstly, some appliances just don't have any sort of switch at all. Once plugged into a wall socket, they are permanently on. This actually includes televisions, which therefore often have a standby mode in order to save power. And these standby modes are often completely incompatible with smart plugs. After all, if you switch power to the TV on via your smart plug, it'll just be stuck in standby mode. You instead need to use an IR blasted device to actually make this work smartly. Smart plugs simply aren't useful for this particular type of electronic item. Ignoring that case completely, the other two types of appliances and switches that you need to consider are ones with mechanical switches and ones with electrical switches. In other words, some devices, such as lamps, have a mechanical switch that actually physically controls the power go into the device. And these are compatible with smart plugs, you'll be pleased to know. This is what the Amazon smart plug sales page says as well. And they offer a further bit of advice too. They say, to check if your device is compatible, turn on the device and unplug the power cord from the outlet. Then plug it back in. If the device is on and works, then it's compatible with the Amazon smart plug, which is fairly good advice. So what about the other type of switch then, electrical switches? Well, these are often found in many kitchen appliances such as washing machines and dishwashers, alongside many computers and laptops, and also most coffee makers, and many other types of appliances as well. These switches don't usually control the actual flow of electricity to the device in a physical way. They sometimes just alter the state of the device, often driven by microcontrollers. Theory aside, what this means is that even if you turn the power on to such a device with a smart plug, you then need to go and click an electric switch before it'll actually come on, which again means that smart plugs aren't that useful. And since most devices actually have an electrical, not mechanical switch, smart plugs are often fairly pointless. So is there any solution to this problem? Well, you have two main options. Firstly, you could just go to a shop and buy a different appliance, get one that comes with a mechanical switch, and these then can be controlled with a smart plug. Alternatively, you could explore something known as SwitchBot, which are really useful little devices that clip onto a device, and this can then be used to smartly press the electric switch. These could be used alongside smart plugs, allowing you to actually turn the power on with the smart plug and then press the electric switch with SwitchBot. However, SwitchBot can actually have automated schedules and routines and all that too, meaning that you could just use SwitchBot instead of a smart plug. It really depends on how you want to control your devices, but in many cases, SwitchBots will actually be better than smart plugs. Now, the one downside of SwitchBot is that the initial purchase price will be closer to $70 when you actually include the fact that you often require a SwitchBot hub. So this option works out more expensive than buying a simple smart plug, which can often be $10. Still, If your device has an electric switch, you don't actually have much choice. Smart plugs just won't work for you, whilst SwitchBot might be a simple, smart solution to your problem. And that's it. That wraps up today's video. Thank you for watching it. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.